All right, welcome back for part two of the Talladega setup video for the Craftsman truck. We've gone through and to kind of refresh our memory of where we're at. We went through and set the front splitter clearance. We sent our roll center. Our caster's been set to get the car stable. We did some ride height adjustments to get the spoiler out of the air. And basically, we've tried to pick up a little bit more speed out of it. We got to pick up just a little bit, but not a whole lot. Of course, there basically, as it comes out, it's about as fast as it's going to get. So that we're to the point now, we're ready to do some long run tests just to make sure that everything is going to be good. And we need to get some actual run laps on the tires so we can see if there's any other adjustments that we're going to need to make to, like, say, cross weight or front rear ballast or something like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to run a 50 lap run, which means we're going to be dealing with a pit stop during the course of the race. In our race session, we're going to bump this up to a 50 lap race. Then we got that set, so make sure our AI opponents are good. We're 84, 85, so we'll go ahead and click on race. And we'll get this test session underway. I'll go ahead and pause it while we wait for this to load up for the sake of time. Alright, we're going to go ahead and get started here. We're going to hit the grid button.
I'd like to say hello to all of our sponsors. Thank you for all you do for us and all of your support. And a big thank you to all these fantastic fans that are here today. Packed house. Great to see. Hello to everybody watching at home. Hope everybody enjoys the race. As of right now, we're short of making it. Alright, it looks like you're going to be on the inside, I think. Pit road is closed. You should be starting behind the 52.
Sure, relative. Okay, since we are going to have to pit, I'm going to go ahead and get my pit command out of the way now. Pit, fuel, full. Maybe. Pit, fuel, full. There it goes. That way when we go on pit road, it'll fill us a full tank of fuel and not do any tires. This is going to be basically be kind of our final run to see how we're doing stability wise, turn in wise, make sure we can hang with the field. And we want to get some tire wear information so that we can tell what our tires are doing. We're also going to run telemetry in this to see if we have any changes to our front right. The biggest thing is as we burn fuel off, I want to make sure that our splitter doesn't start hitting, which sometimes they can. Boy, they see an open hole, they go for it, don't they?
All
now to see if we can make the full 50 laps off record this time. We'll be right back. not doing too bad. She's actually driving pretty good. She pretty much is staying where I wonder where I put it. Probably are going to be our last scheduled practice before we actually run the official race once they officially start the season. We'll be right back. 20 laps in, she's driving pretty good. The turn-in's all right. I can live with it. The exit's okay, and it's relatively stable.
Still there. Three wide inside.
over here to the outside and let the guys go.
Okay, my man, stay on. Fingers off the road. Inside. Two inside. Count the hole.
Taking the lead.
Here we go, fellas. Five away. At your mark now. Turn in. You're going to be leading on me. Go.
Watch your speed. Careful, because there's going to be slick coming out of here.
Outside. You're outside if you want it.
Are you out of fuel?
Get out of the way.
Outside.
You're out of fuel.
Clear high.
drafting partner when I come off pit road, but that's how it goes sometimes. Got toward the end of that run, she started to feel a little free.
56.303.
And we should now have enough laps on our tires where we should be able to figure out if we need to do any other adjustments, like cross weight or anything like that.
Outside only. Clear high.
my biggest challenge is when somebody sneaks up in my spot, blind spot, and I can't see them. Stable setup, you can't drive away. You just kind of stuff.
Thank you.
only a 50 lap run. Let's take a look at our tires. So we just finished the race, or the qualifying session, or not qualifying session, but test session rather. And I want to check to see what our tires are looking like. So we'll pull up our checklist, then record our tire information after a 50 lap run. And what is our when did we get closed? It must have. I don't know why, but unless that program, unless my stint analyzer crashed, which has been known to do. So unfortunately, I'm not going to have average information. All I'm going to have is what MoTeC captured. So let's see what MoTeC did give me. Unfortunately, all I can really get out of this is the fastest laps. Since Stint Analyzer didn't stick around for us, we don't have any date. Quarter tire data anyway, though. I know that was a 50 lap run. Our left front is 100%. Right front was 97%. Right rear is 94. And we could probably stand to back that crossway off just a tick. Back that off one. up one. Back that off one. And up that one, one. That should take care of our camber issue that we're seeing there, where the camber is a little bit off. 94, 94, 95, 97, 97, 98. That should get us close on the camber. Now the next elephant in the room is going to be our cross weight, which is off just a tick. So we're going to go ahead and soften that right rear. Let's see what our cross weight actually is at 53.9. And we're going to change this over to cross weights. Now that we made some changes to it, we're going to have to run another test session a little bit later, but not right now. And I probably won't take you guys along for that particular ride. But at any rate, that will basically wrap it up for the setup video for Talladega. This was the part two of that video. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel and stay tuned, because we'll be continuing this series where we teach you how to build setups for the Craftsman truck. We have a whole bunch more tracks to do. We have the entire season once we get in past Daytona of setups to build for the 2024 season. So stick around or stay tuned. We'll be back to basically build the setups for those. Until then, keep her between the wall and the infield, and keep the greasy side down. Thanks for watching.